Hey everyone, in this episode of Azure Essentials Show, we will discuss what Azure Verified Modules are and how they offer best practices for your infrastructure as code. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Azure Essentials Show whiteboarding series. I'm your host, Harshita Putta. Joining us today is Sebastian Graf from the Industry Solutions Delivery Team at Microsoft. And today we will discuss what Azure Verified Modules are and how they accelerate and standardize the deployment of your Azure resources. Hey, Sebastian, welcome to the show.
Hey, Harshita, thanks for having me.
Awesome. So can you tell our viewers about what Azure Verified Modules are and how do we use them?
Sure. Let's start with the customer pain point. For example, developers can be quite confused or frustrated when they work with infrastructure as code modules, and especially when they are not officially affiliated or supported by Microsoft, right? And that can be lead to inconsistencies or errors, or even then to frustration and can be problematic, right? From Microsoft solution is Azure Verified Modules, which is AVM in short, which is an initiative which pretty much sets the standards how a good infrastructure as code module should look like. You can think about an Azure Verified Module as a composable building block, which encapsulates a group of Azure resources with the purpose of a dedicated task, right? So you can think about an Azure storage account module, for example. It can deploy blob services, file services, and queue services, whereas a single Azure resource from Bicep can only deploy one single resource.
That's awesome. So what is unique about AVMs that the other infrastructure as code solutions don't offer today?
Partially said it already, so it's pretty much about setting an aligned single strategy and a definition for infrastructure as code modules from Microsoft, which pretty much allows to accelerate existing projects, customer projects, but also Microsoft projects, such things as application learning zone accelerators, but also the building of an Azure Verified Modules library, right? Each module has its own dedicated Microsoft employee as an owner. So this is your point of contact in this perspective. And the big selling point, what we are often seeing why the community loves our modules is that it's trusted and supported by Microsoft. And we have certain units, integration tests, and end-to-end tests, which pretty much makes when you pick a module from the library, you can be sure that it's actually working and it actually was tested and can be deployed. And as the last thing is, everything's backed up by the AVM core team. If you have an issue, just raise a Microsoft customer support ticket, right? And everything is pretty much also backed up by the Azure product groups.
Well, that's fantastic, Sebastian. I think these being supported and created by Microsoft will give our customers more trustworthy solutions. Can you show us an example of how to create a sample resource using AVMs?
Yes, of course. Let me show you. So let's start with the Azure Verified Modules landing page. You see on the left side, we have on the TSC, we have some things like module indexes for Bicep and Terraform, the concepts, we do specification, but also the help and support section. And if you want to contribute, the contributing section. So let's choose a module. Let's choose a Bicep module. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the current published modules. And also what you can see here, what I already mentioned, in this table, you can see for each respective module which is available, the corresponding owner. So you can just click on it and get in touch with the individual. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to choose the Azure OpenAI module, which we all know is the cognitive services. I'm selecting it. And what it does, it forwards me to the GitHub page where it shows the source code of the actual Azure Verified module. So what you can see here is pretty much the navigation. And what I'm going to do, I'm picking an example, which is what I also mentioned already. It's tested. It made sure that it's deployable. So I'm choosing an Azure AI services with deployments. I'm expanding the Bicep module. And I'm making a copy. And then I'm going to switch over to my Visual Studio Code, taking this code, pasting it, and everything what I do here is I'm pretty much just adjusting the version. Remember, you have to make sure that your Bicep extension is installed in VS Code to make sure that this IntelliSense feature is working. I'm also changing the location, and I'm just adding a couple of names. And then I would go ahead and pretty much deploy this module.
This is great, Sebastian. Can you share some of the useful resources for our viewers to learn more about AVMs?
Yes, of course. Let me switch back to the AVM landing page. And on the TOC section, you can see we have a big help and support section, which gives you all the links in terms of module support, our SLAs, if you want to raise a new GitHub issue, or even if you just want to contribute and propose a new module. We also have a lot of resources to share in terms of creating support tickets, if you want to ask questions, if you just want to read our FAQs. But also, we'd love you to have you join our monthly community calls, which in all these links you can find down in the section below.
Thank you, Sebastian, for sharing all this great information about Azure Verified Modules. To our viewers who want to know more about AVMs, and if you have any questions and comments, please post in the comment section below. And do subscribe to our channel if you don't want to miss our future episodes. Until next time, thank you for watching Azure Essentials Show.